the journey from West India to North India. Hello friends, this is Dhanno, a motorcycle. It is a very fast motorcycle. I think it is trying to say something.
Look, there is so much traffic and the streets are so crowded in the city, because of which I cannot ride fast and there is no fun. There is a lot of noise here. Since a few days, my rider Shankar has been wanting to ride from Mumbai to Jammu and Kashmir. Today morning, he mentioned that we will be leaving tomorrow morning for the biking expedition. I am very excited.
Do you all want to join us for the expedition? We will have to specially pack for this trip. Shankar and Dhanno will begin to pack for this biking expedition. Till then, you all make a list of the things we need to pack. Come with me. Learning objective: A. To experience a road journey. B. To gain information about few western regions of India. C. To gain information about Leh, the highest region in India.
Dhanno, tomorrow morning we have to leave for a long trip. I am bored watching the same tall houses here in Mumbai. For a few days, let us go and experience the clean air of the mountains. Come, let's pack. Where did my list go? There it is. I shall quickly go over the things to pack now.
Yes, Shankar, let us pack. Tell me what all is in the list.
One tent, two sleeping bag, three plastic sheet, four warm clothes, five food items which will stay fresh. Oh, the most important thing, my camera. I will take a lot of pictures on the trip and save them as memories.
Friends, have you ever gone on a road trip?
Shankar, you packed food for yourself. But what about me? What will I eat?
Of course, Dhanno. How can I forget? Look here, cans of petrol. You will need this to ride fast on the road.
Yes, if this finishes, then I can get a refill at a petrol pump. It is a very long journey from Mumbai to Jammu and Kashmir. I too have packed warm clothes. Shankar, did you pack the map of India? Can you show me the states we will pass by in our trip?
Thanks for reminding me, Dhanno. Let me keep a map of India too. Look, we are here in Mumbai. We shall pass through Gujarat, Rajasthan, while going to Delhi. From Delhi, we shall proceed towards Himachal Pradesh and reach Jammu and Kashmir.
Wow! We will pass through so many states before reaching Kashmir. Gujarat is where Mahatma Gandhiji was born, and Rajasthan is such a colorful state. And then Delhi is the capital of India. Am I right, Shankar?
Yes, Dhanno, you are very intelligent.
Thank you, Shankar. I am very excited. I am going to sleep. I saw on the map that the distance between Mumbai and Delhi is 1400 kilometers. You also go and sleep, Shankar. We shall meet in the morning. Good night.
Shankar and Dhanno go to sleep. Next morning.
Shankar, good morning. Get up, it is morning. If we leave early, there will be less traffic on the road. Get ready soon.
I am ready, Dhanno. Let us check everything once more.
Shankar and Dhanno check everything once and then they leave on their biking expedition.
Let's go, Dhanno.
Shankar and Dhanno reach Gujarat from Mumbai. There, they rest for a day.
Thanno, Gujarat is such a beautiful state. The capital of Gujarat is Gandhinagar.
Look, Shankar, the houses are so beautiful in Gujarat. These houses are made of such intricate and beautiful woodwork. I also observe that the houses are very beautifully decorated with mirrors and beads and shells.
Yes, Dhanu, these houses are so interesting. Look, Dhanu, my favorite dhokla and khakra. These are a few of the famous food specialities of Gujarat.
After a few hours, Shankar and Dhanu reached Rajasthan.
It seems as if we have reached a city of kings in Rajasthan. It is such a historical place.
Is Jaipur the capital of Rajasthan?
Yes, correct, Dhanu. Jaipur is the capital of Rajasthan. It is also known as the Pink City. Most of the houses here are of pink color. Rajasthan has a rich history and it has natural beauty too. The palaces, lakes, and monuments of Rajasthan are famous all over the world.
Shankar and Dhanu purchased a few colorful puppets from Rajasthan and spent the night there. From there, they left the next morning and reached Delhi. It took them 4 days to reach from Mumbai to Delhi.
Shankar, Delhi is such a historical place. There are many monuments here, like the Red Fort, Qutub Minar, and the India Gate.
That is true, Dhanu. Delhi is the capital of India. We find a lot of political and historical attractions here. But look, the houses in Delhi are similar to Mumbai. They are also made up of bricks, cement and glass. I want to reach the mountains soon. There we will find houses made up of wood with snow-covered sloping terraces.
Yes, even I cannot wait now. But now the road ahead is going to get steep and narrower. I will be able to climb slowly.
Shankar and Dhanu left Delhi and reached Manali in 2 days. Manali is a district in Himachal Pradesh.
Finally, I can breathe in fresh and crisp air. It is so peaceful in the mountains.
Yes, Shankar, I'm also feeling very nice. However, the roads ahead are narrower and steep. The roads to Jammu and Kashmir and further to Leh and Ladakh are difficult roads.
I think I will assemble my tent and let us stay the night here. We shall begin our climb upwards tomorrow morning. It is so cold, but living in a tent will be a different experience.
Shankar, you go to sleep and I shall guard outside the tent.
It is extremely cold here. This tent will protect me. You take care of yourself. Let us meet in the morning.
He goes and sleeps inside. And Dhanu stays put outside, guarding the tent. Next morning, Shankar wakes up to the chirping of birds. And both Dhanu and he observe the sunrise.
Dhanu, let us now leave for Leh. The road ahead is going to be difficult.
Let us go. I'm ready.
Shankar and Dhanu rode on some difficult roads for some hours and finally reached Leh. It rains very little in Leh. There are snow-covered mountains in Leh and it is a cold desert.
Look, Dhanu, we have reached Leh. It is so cold here. I have never visited such a geographical area in my life. It's a cold desert.
Yes, Shankar. Leh looks beautiful. I think Rajasthan is a hot desert and Leh is a cold desert.
Leh is known as the terrace of the world. It is at an altitude of 3,500 meters above the sea level. It is famous for Buddhist monasteries and trekking areas. Look, Dhanno, Leh is so peaceful. The houses here are so beautiful. And I observe, they are all white.
Shankar, look at these clouds, which look like cotton. I will now ride slowly so that we can observe the beauty of Leh.
On the way, Shankar and Dhanno see a lot of Buddhist monks.
Jule jule.
Look, Shankar, I think these monks want to tell us something.
Yes, Dhanno, let us stop and talk to them. Maybe they want to tell us something. Hello, how are all of you? My name is Shankar and this is my motorbike, Dhanno.
The Buddhist monks smile at both of them and says Jule Jule, which means welcome in their native language. One of the Buddhist monks was a small child who wanted to take Shankar and Dhanno to his house.
What is your name, child?
My name is Samir. Jule Jule, do you ride fast, Dhanno? Can I sit on you and ride?
Yes, Samir. Come, I will help you.
Shankar helps Samir to get on Dhanno and takes him for a short ride.
How did you feel, Samir?
It was a fun ride. Where are both of you from? You don't look like you belong to Leh.
Samir, we have come from Mumbai.
Oh, Mumbai. Where is Mumbai?
Look, Samir, this is the map of India. Here is Mumbai and this is Leh. We have traveled from Mumbai to Leh.
Really? It is very far off from here.
Samir, tell me, how do you stay in such extreme cold? I am freezing.
The minimum temperature in Leh goes down to minus 30 degrees Celsius.
Yes, it is very cold. I am used to it. But why don't both of you come to my house and drink tea? Then I shall take you around to show Leh.
All the houses are white here. I am not able to differentiate between any two houses.
Look, there is my house.
Shankar and Dhanno were very tired. It was extremely cold. So they thought that they would rest for some time and drink something hot. They would also get an opportunity to look at a local house in Leh. Friends, welcome to Leh. It has been a long journey till here. Let us rest for some time and meet in the next video where we shall explore Leh with Samir. Then we will proceed towards Ladakh and Srinagar on narrower roads and difficult terrain. Till then, you look for the names of the capitals of the states through which Shankar and Dhanno passed by. I shall leave you with a hint. The answer to this question are hidden in this video. We shall meet soon.